Girly, girly, chickens, girly. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. How are you? I've missed you. I feel like we haven't sat down and chatted for a minute. So here we are. And this is going to be, it's not a what's new in my wardrobe. I know it's that kind of setting. It's that kind of vibe. But this is more of a city girl. London, Paris, Milan. Wherever you're going, your little city trip. Because I know you probably have one booked. Everyone's on that vibe right now. The whole world's in Paris. Everyone's in Paris. I feel so left out. So if you have Paris FOMO, don't worry. I'm with you, girly. So if you are planning to go to Paris or London or any gorgeous city trip, that's what we're going to talk about today. So I'm going to talk you through what I wore in London. Myself and Sambe were in London for the weekend and it was absolutely fabulous. I want to move there. Put me in London right now. I really want to move there. I do see myself living there. No time soon, but it's just a dream. It's an absolute dream. So we had so much fun and of course, I had the outfits planned. I was a little bit last minute with my planning, to be honest, but we'll get through that. I was last minute with my outfit plans, but we did it. We got it. So I'll show you the Insta pics as per. That's kind of how we do what's in my wardrobe. I'll show you my Insta pics and we talk through the outfits. I'm also going to talk about packing and planning for a city girl trip. I packed a cabin bag. I had to only have a cabin bag. I could have been bougie and brought like an underneath bag, but I need to get a grip some reality. And I look like a priest. Oh my God, I look like a priest. I think that's why I can't look myself. I love looking like a priest. I look really serious today. I look like I'm going to a funeral. Is my soul feeling a little bit dark today? I woke up, you know what I'm realizing, girls? Every day isn't a great day, but there's good days, there's bad days, okay? And I'm really hard on myself when it's not a good day, but it doesn't matter, okay? So I think I woke up a little bit doom and gloom, obviously. Can we tell? I look very serious. I look like I'm at an interview. I think the hair goes with it, but you can't see the hair, but I think this and a claw clip is the look. But anyway, going off the rail. So, you know, I did a cabin bag, so I could only have one coat. One coat. Because, girls, I'm also trying to be more of a staples gal. I'm sick of getting sick of my clothes. I don't want that anymore. I used to buy too much trendy shit. I'm now just getting the staples. I know I overbuy anyway, but I'm a staple shopper now, okay? I'm in all black. I do love all black. We're going staples, okay? Especially for if you're only cabin bag, you're going to want staple packing, rewearable shit. I do think for packing, plan the outfits. Don't throw in a load of different bits. Plan the outfits. This isn't a pack with me though, but we're just going to talk about it. So two pairs of shoes and one coat. I was really proud of myself for that. I know that sounds ridiculous, but we did it and I'm going to show you how we did it. Let's talk about it. Let's just talk about it, okay? So let's go through what we wore. Let's start with the, yeah, let's go. Let's go day by day. Outfit picks. Okay. So, day one. At the end of this video, I'll put in the vlog part of London. I vlogged a little bit of it, so we'll just put that in the end for some shits and giggles. If you enjoy a good vlog. But let's talk about the outfit. So, first day, we were wandering around. Beautiful. London is so beautiful in the right part. So, this outfit is my favorite skirt. I, of course, got it in black because this is a staple. You know I love satin. I'm obsessed with satin. I think satin looks really expensive. It makes you feel expensive. It makes you look luxurious. Satin is it for me. Cream satin, black satin. Then I also love like a pink or yellow satin for a special occasion. Satin. Okay, girls? Satin. So this beautiful skirt, but you can't even really see it in the photo. Kind of got a glimpse of it in my TikTok. A few people were asking about it. I got a size medium and it's from a brand called MK. Like, okay. Okay. I love it. So it's MKAE. I think it's a Copenhagen based. I could have totally made that up. Absolutely love it. I got a size medium in that. So beautiful. It sits so beautifully. It goes with everything. That is an absolute staple skirt and you can wear that in summer as well. So that's going to serve us all year round. Okay. So staples queen. Okay. So love that. The knit, sorry, it's in the wash. That is Zara. Loved that as well. Got a size small. I'll link it below. So soft, so comfy. Again, it's going to go with everything. And then of course, girlies, I did absolutely treat myself to the Prada loafers. I don't think we've talked about these yet.
Bye.
Oh, they need a bit of a clean after London. They need a bit of a clean. So these are the Prada Monolith loafers. I'm absolutely obsessed. Massive platform on them, which I'm obsessed with. See the Prada logo, super comfy, like they're not cutting or anything. I got a UK 5 and they are a little bit big, like I have insoles in there because I'm typically between a 4 and a 5. If I had the choice, I would have got a 4.5, but with these they sell out so fast, I don't think there is a choice. Like if they're all in stock, you'll have a wide range of choice, but I couldn't even believe when the 5 did come in stock. I got a notification from Farfetch they were in stock. I was stalking Farfetch every day of my life. I think they have like UK 8 size left. There is the odd time you'll find them, but I couldn't believe when I found a UK 5. Would have loved a 4.5, but it doesn't matter. I really do recommend if you're looking to invest in a loafer. Now, I'll link some dupes below for cheaper, more affordable loafers. They have some on ASOS, and there's so many loafers out there. This really just was a treat myself moment because I'm just obsessed with them. They're my new little babies, okay? I absolutely adore them. So I wore them as well with these mesh socks. I'll link the mesh socks. They're ASOS. Love a good mesh sock. Oh, I also wore these mesh socks the other week, and whoa, you girlies popped off for them. So I'll link them as well. The little crisscross ones, they're so cute. Just think mesh socks with a loafer look so cute because it's almost giving off a knee-high boot effect, but it's a loafer. Like, it's just a two-in-one kind of look for me. I just love it. So this is the coat I brought with me. Actually, so this is my little airport photo, and this is when you girlies first saw the coat, and you're like, where's the coat from, bitch? You girls are in the DMs. Bitch, 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 bitch. Link the coat, link the coat, link the coat. Gorgeous coat, ASOS design. So it already looks a bit worn. Just after the one weekend, it does look worn, but I kind of like that look with these coats. Like, it still looks cute. I think it's called like the Hero Dad coat, Granddad coat or whatever. She's fabulous. I'm gonna be living in her. Adore her color. You know I love chocolate brown. Chocolate brown goes with everything. Chocolate brown is a staple. So here I just threw over my shoulders because it wasn't quite the outfit. I knew I wanted a picture in the coat, but I didn't. This wasn't the outfit planned for the coat, but it was cold. So I had the coat thrown over my shoulders. You know, so this is the one coat I wore to the airport and it got me through. So I wore it every day because it was cold in London. We were lucky, it wasn't ever really raining, a bit of drizzle on one of the mornings, but that was it. And then Drunk Sam did bring me to the NFL. He booked tickets when he was drunk and then we went to the NFL on the Sunday. That's a story for another day. Okay, so the outfit I just showed you, that was Saturday. We got there on a Saturday. We went for a surprise party, so I wasn't really able to post much about it until the surprise had happened because I wasn't going to be that bitch that ruined the surprise party, okay? So day two, then we wake up, go out for brunch before going to the NFL. Yes, I wore this to the NFL. I don't care. I had no other choice. I did not pack knowing I was going to the fucking NFL. I didn't know I was going to a football stadium. If I did know what I've changed anything about it, probably fucking not, because I did not have room to be packing any more outfits, and all I care about is looking cute, okay? So yes, I went to the NFL like this and I don't care. Okay, so this was my outfit. We were out for brunch in the morning. That was so much fun. Got a little coffee. And so this brown jumper, sorry girls, it's actually last year mango, but it was on ASOS. But of course I'll find you a dupe. I will find you a chocolate brown jumper. It won't be too hard to find. I'll find you a dupe and link it below for you. Chocolate brown jumper is a staple. It's a keeper. It's gonna go with so much of your stuff. I love a knit jumper. I think knit jumpers can look really dressy or casual, whatever way you need them to look. You're gonna be able to dress it up and down. Mm-hmm. So girls, you've probably seen this Zara set on TikTok. A gorgeous girly tagged me in a TikTok and was like, Bestie, you need this. And I said, Bestie, I do. And I got it. I'm obsessed with the skirt. So this is the skirt and I got a size medium. So I actually ran to the Zara store. I'm always Zara online, but I ran to Zara the day before flying, wanting and looking for this. Found it, was delighted. But they only had the blazer in a size small, and I wish I got a medium, even a large, because it just, I love an oversized blazer, you know that, and I love a blazer that will go over a knit jumper, but the jumper was actually too thick for the small to look nice over. It just looked too stuffy, and I hate that. So I wore it over my shoulders, but I do regret getting the small. I am upset I got the small. I might end up actually selling this blazer because I took the tag off in London thinking it was perfect. It was not perfect. So I might have to sell that. It is a pity. I just, you know, I love an oversized blazer. So the skirt is perfect. And even the skirt on its own, I actually just wish I got the skirt. I love the skirt. The blazer, because I got the wrong size, I just shouldn't have done it, but I was just in such a rush. The skirt is adorable. Now, I know I'm talking about staple clothing. I know green might not be a staple to you, but the skirt, I think you'll get use out of. The skirt, I do think you'd get use out of these pieces, because what I do love about a cohort set is you can wear the skirt on its own, you can wear the blazer on its own, whereas it's a cohort set. So you do get more than one outfit out of it, and you get a piece out of it. So do with that info what you will. I know this photo here doesn't really photograph the skirt, but I'm sure you've seen it has that beautiful slit. It's a funny shape, like it is a mini skirt shape, but it's actually very cute on. Still kind of high-waisted because I don't like a low-rise skirt, oh my god. And it's not too short. So that's a medium, and I'd recommend sizing up in the blazer. So I'm actually wearing my Ganni boots in this photo, which you can't really see, which again, I wore these to the fucking NFL stadium. They didn't get wrecked, thank God. They're still doing good. These are also my babies. So my loafers and my Ganni boots are my babies. Cannot live without. And they were like my investment shoes for autumn winter. I do love the Ganni welly boot style. Don't put it past me. I might end up buying them. They're cheaper than this. They're more affordable than these, than this style. Oh God, they did get a bit wrecked, didn't they? Oh, makes me really sad. But gotta wear them. If you pay money for them, get your wear out of them. They do take a bit of breaking in. They're very skinny on the leg. a little bit suffocating. I was wearing them for the whole day and it was a little bit tiring. They're kind of heavy. I did get a blister breaking them in, but then after breaking them in, they're all good. They're doing me good. Mm-hmm. Then, girlies, my last day outfit. So we were literally only there for 2 nights. So it was a very fleeting trip. Zara tank top, obsessed, chocolate brown. So I also wore this to the airport. I just think a tank and leggings or trousers are so cute for the airport under a coat, especially for this weather. I love a tracksuit for the airport either. But if you want to feel a bit more glam and you kind of don't have the choice to be wearing a tracksuit, you might need to wear your outfit over. I don't love wearing clothes that I'm going to want to wear there for the airport because travel can get a bit stinky, a little bit sweaty. But if you have to, you have to. I just wore this little tank and leggings under the coat for the airport. And then, because I just knew for the last day that the coat was the outfit. The coat was really the outfit. So I just wore this cute little tank top underneath. And they're my SLA, the label, white trousers. Love them, wear them all the time. And my big coat. My big coat, and I love her so much. And girls, okay, I know, I've really splurged. I did splurge recently, but it's just like, I kind of do that. I just splurge on a few autumn winter items that I know are gonna be timeless and serve me every autumn winter, okay? So I got this gorgeous Louis Vuitton petit sac plat and I'm obsessed. She's so gorgeous. She's very hard to get. I found her on Jean Vintage. I couldn't believe when I found her. She's very hard to get. I don't think she's discontinued, but Louis Vuitton just don't have her in stock anywhere. And I couldn't believe when I found her. So I'm obsessed. So she's top handle or she's cross body, shoulder. Beautiful. She's my new baby and I'm obsessed. I really am obsessed with her. I felt like she kind of makes an outfit and she made that outfit. The outfit was really nothing without her, you know? So girls, that was how I packed, really, as a city girl in a cabin bag, wore the coat over, packed day one outfit, day two outfit. I managed to fit the shoes in the cabin bag and wore my trainers for the airport. Was proud of that because I knew for day three I'd want comfy runners. So I couldn't believe I got the boots. Oh no, I carried the boots in a tote bag as a carry-on bag as well as my cabin bag. So you could have done that. You could have done the whole weekend in your loafers. Because you're probably better than I am. Yeah, you're probably much better at this than I am. So you could have done that whole thing with one pair of shoes. But of course I had to bring two. But I was quite proud of myself for getting the boots and loafers. No, I got the loafers in the suitcase, boots in a tote bag under my arm. Outfit one, outfit two, outfit three. Makeup bag, toiletry bag, toiletries, all minis. Be minimal, girls. Like, the hotel's gonna have a mini. I have to bring my own mini shampoo and conditioner, but the hotel's gonna have a mini body wash. Bring your mini deo. Makeup liquids is a bit of a bitch. I flew through Dublin Airport with them all, like, in the case, no bother. But then I went to Gatwick coming home, and they emptied my whole makeup bag. But they didn't take anything, thank God. They didn't take anything. But I had it all in the case, like a fucking idiot. You just seem to get away with that in Dublin. I don't know. Obviously, for a city trip, you're doing a lot of walking, so you're gonna need your comfy shoes. Poor Sam was in a new pair of shoes that he hadn't even broken in yet for the whole weekend. He bought one pair for the whole weekend and he was in bits. So be clever. So I knew the Pradas would be okay. I knew I'd broken in the Ghani boots enough. So don't bring new shoes. Bring shoes you've broken in and that you still feel sexy and cute in, but you gotta be able to walk, okay, girls? It's gonna ruin your trip if you can't walk around your city girl trip, okay? Oh, I was asked about fitting things in here. Yeah, that was probably my downfall, was I didn't have like a bigger handbag. I don't really own a bigger handbag. It's on my list. I really need a bigger, like, I love the YSL bags. Obviously I want a Chanel, but that's way down the line. I do love a YSL, like the big YSL bags, just one of those kind of bags. I do need a bigger bag. That's what I learned on that trip, was, you know, because in here I had like my powder, lip products, wallet. But for a long day out, like, I kind of needed my charger. My camera was in my hand the whole time for vlogging, which was so dodgy. I don't know how my camera made it home. She is fabulous. City trip, I would recommend bringing a better, bigger handbag if you can. That's the one thing I missed, having a nice, generous bag. Because you're gone. You go out for the day. You're gone for the whole day, you know? I do think layers are important. This time of year, it's getting cold. London did get cold. Thank God for my big coat. But if I was going any later, you'd probably want a scarf. Oh my God, gloves soon. Yeah, like, I really want to book a Christmas trip, girls. And that, I think, would be really difficult to do cabin bag packing with. So I'm going to have to book a Christmas market trip and experiment for you. Okay, fine. I'll do it. I really want to go to, like, the Copenhagen Christmas markets or something. Tell me where to go. Tell me, where are the nice Christmas markets? I did Brussels for Christmas before. Well, it was after Christmas and we kind of missed the markets, but I did love Brussels. But yeah, tell me a nice European city Christmas markets vibe. Edinburgh is meant to be nice too. Anyway, or Vienna? No, let me know anyway. I actually ordered this, but didn't end up bringing it with me. I didn't bring this with me because I got the green Zara outfit instead, but I can't wait to wear this. I think this is fabulous. And this is Collusion or ASOS Design. This is ASOS Design, and it's a satin blazer. I got a UK 10, so it's kind of big, but it's a satin blazer dress, or you can wear it open. I'll link that below because I do think that's really cute, because I just think blazers are fabulous. We love blazers, but the fact that satin makes it a little bit different, maybe a little bit dressy. Shoulder pads, so I'll link that for you as well. So girlies, everything will be linked below. That was the London City Girl trip. So now I'll insert the vlog part. Bring you with us a little bit. You know I'm a bit shy of vlogging, you know. I'm either too drunk or I don't know, you know. So anyway, I'll put in the vlog now. All the links will be below. I really hope you enjoyed. Oh, I forgot to say, I always tell you that I'm typically a UK 8 on the top, UK 10 on the bottom. Apparently I'm like 5'2". I'm not really sure. I'm quite short anyway, for reference. So ask me any questions below. There's something in my eye. I'll leave all the links below for you. And now enjoy the vlog. It's a bit chaotic. And I'll see you next week. I love you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Love you. Bye. So we're in London. We actually flew in yesterday for Sam's cousin's surprise party. It was so much fun. So that was last night. So I didn't vlog anything yesterday because we were kind of just... We got here at like 2, got into our hotel. You're not getting a hotel room tour because there is no hotel room tour. It's a shoebox. Sam doesn't fit in it. It's cute. It's quaint. Sam drunkenly booked us NFL tickets.
We spent so much money.
We're going to the NFL. We're going for brunch now. Sam's obsessed with the NFL, so we're going. And they're playing in the Spurs stadium, and he's Spurs. No, I'm going to love it. I know I'm going to love it. We went to a Spurs game in London 3 years ago, and I loved it. So I know I'll love it, but just a bit wild. So let's just get drunk, you know?
And you're dressed for New York.
Yeah, fuck's sake.
Even though I'm in New York.
I'm in, yeah, I'm dressed for the Jets, apparently, by accident. Obviously, wouldn't be like me to fucking coordinate for a team, but... Okay, my arm's going dead. I'll check back in with you.
You got chips as well. Oh,
thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, man.
I lost my lip gloss and my lip color is way too dark.
Oh, you are?
My lip color is way too dark. Right. I need to get a lip gloss. Sam's hanging.
I'm not. Do you know when you're like.
He's in denial.
And like you feel alright, but you feel like your eyes are popping out of your head.
Yeah.
So like I feel alright, but I feel like I look right. I do look right.
So we're getting a quick hot chocolate and coffee here, and we're gonna go to the end of that. What am I gonna drink? Like wine. I have wine.
Like she asked me these questions. No, you asked me okay, this. Like, the only time, no, I'm not. No, the only time I ever got a football game is with my dad and my dad. So we drink beer. I don't know. I'm
we
sure
drink
they
beer. Well. Okay, girlies, we'll pop back in. I'll let you know if we get our popcorn.
I might not be with Sophie later.
Okay, love you. Bye.
So cute. Hiya.
No talking about my thoughts, babe. Just talking when she saw the cake. You know, it cost a quarter, right?
Atlanta Falcons.
Which was who you were supporting? Me, you were supporting.
Yeah, I bet on the Atlanta Falcons and they won.
That was not the best.
Hello.
We are the underground.
We are the cheese.
We are the cheese. London. Going home to our hotel. Then we're meeting Caitlin and Charlie.
Oh my god, there we go.
Baby cakes. Sam's struggling to lift this glass. Thank you.
No, I'm good.
We're all good. Thank you.